Howdy, hey. How you doing, babe? You good? You straight? You sure? All right. So just when I thought I was gonna have a day completely void of the fucking feels, I almost cried today. And I can definitely understand now how people will go through certain shit and they will lock themselves in a fucking room and just be depressed. I get it. Because this shit is a lot. This shit is a fucking lot. And I totally understand why a person wouldn't want to share this type of information, because it's kind of like low key embarrassing. It's a little embarrassing, but at the same time, it's like, soon as I fix my face to be embarrassed, then all of a sudden I'm thinking, like, what's the point of being embarrassed? Like, there's no reason for you to feel embarrassed because people do this shit. People manipulate people like that. People do this shit to a T. Like, sometimes this is somebody's fucking job. This is what they do. They're just really fucking good at what they do. So I had a good day today with the girls. Took them out. We got out the house and did something all on our own. And we haven't done that in a long time. Like, we went out to eat and everything was just magical. Just me and my girls. But before, no, it was after, I want to say. No, it was before. It was before we actually got there. I had this period of my mind just went to this place of like me and my ex-fiance together because my birthday had just passed. And then we're enjoying, me and the girls are getting ready to enjoy Veterans Day, which my ex-fiance was a veteran as well, or is a veteran because he's still alive. He is a veteran. But it just made me like teary-eyed for a moment because I was just thinking about like how he would be there with me, how we could be enjoying that together. I was thinking about how, my birthday passed and I really didn't do anything, which I didn't have nothing to do, nothing. I was just happy to be alive, child. I was just happy to make it to see another one. And I don't know, I just started thinking about shit that he would do, like how he would get me like a card or something, or just do something. Even if he would just say happy birthday to me. Like, he would make it seem like he wasn't gonna do anything, and then he would just pop out with something. It'd be something small. But I don't know. I just missed that today. I just missed the presence of the person just being like, wait until the kids go to sleep to give me something for my birthday that they've been just holding for me. And it's. I think where I get the embarrassed part, where it feels embarrassing, is because, again, like I always say, from the outside looking in, it's like, how the fuck could you miss somebody or have feelings for somebody still who is into children? And it's like, you hear that and you think, like, yeah, you're right. But then at the same time, it's like as human beings, the feelings don't just go away. People will lie to you and try to make you believe that, oh, if something traumatic happened, this is how they're gonna handle it, and this is what they're gonna do, and this is how they're gonna feel. But you really honestly don't know anything about anything until you're in the midst of going through some shit. Like everybody will say some shit about, well, if somebody try to do something to my kid, somebody try to fuck with my kid, I'm gonna fuck them up. True. I believe that. I believe it. But my thing is, how are you gonna fuck them up? In what manner are you gonna fuck them up? When we say that, most of the time we mean like get a person back, beat their ass, do whatever the fuck, because it's our kid. But it's like, what if that's not an option? What if it's a different way? Like, I almost feel like I don't have the. I have the justice because the police and everybody did their job. But then it's like, where's my justice of feeling like, so the person knows that I know what the fuck they did and I did this shit to them. Like, where's my get back? But this is get back enough. Like, what the person is going through, what I have to go through is like get back enough. And it's not even like, I'm never saying that shit in no way of like, oh, you did this, so this is what the fuck you deserve type of shit. Like, even if I feel like a motherfucker deserves some shit, I'm not gonna sit there and throw that shit in your face because everybody got issues. Everybody got shit that they're trying to work through. And that's just the kind of person that I am. Like, I want to always see the good in people. And I feel like because I want to see the good in people, I get the short end of the stick. And that's where that falling in love with potential shit has got to go out the fucking window. It really does. But I get it. I get how this is something really hard for other people to share. So I hope that with me sharing, somebody somewhere will feel like they are not alone and will understand these same feelings. Like, it's hard to turn that shit off. Even if somebody, if you're in love with somebody, I'm talking about this is just your fucking person. You in love. There's nobody else in the world for you. There's nobody else that you fucking see. And this person kills somebody that you love. Like, yeah, you're gonna be fucked up about it. But that doesn't mean that the feelings just go the fuck away. Like, they don't go anywhere. And I feel like that's the part that people struggle with the most is the feelings, because it's like when somebody hurts you and do some wrong shit to you or somebody that you love, like, you don't want to have no feelings toward this person other than hatred or disgust or just the shit that's not fucking good. Like, you don't want to feel anything towards them that's good. You don't want to think of them as, you know, I love this person, I miss this person, I wish I could see this person, all these different things. You don't want to think about that shit. But again, because of how we're wired, you can't just shut that shit off. You can say out of your mouth that you shut that shit off, but in your heart, in your soul, it don't get shut off. It takes time. And if you don't give yourself the proper time that it takes or that you need to deal with some shit, then you fuck around and start masking it with shit that you don't need, like fucking with other people too soon, bringing other people into your fucked up energy field that don't need to be there, and then fucking up other people's lives. You binge on shit, you do excess in shit, you know, too much smoking, too much drinking. Too much fucking, too much whatever the fuck. And that's the place that I'm not trying to go down. I'm not trying to do too much of any fucking thing. If I feel like something is happening and I'm abusing it and I'm doing too much, I'm stepping the fuck back. But all in all, what's really the point of this whole thing is the fact that, like I said, you just can't turn the feelings off. No matter how much you want to, no matter how much you don't want to look at the person in this light. But there's feelings attached to certain things. Certain experiences in your life have feelings attached to it, and certain people attached to it, certain songs that you hear. That's what it was. That's what the fuck it was. We were in the car and we were riding, and a song came on that he loved. He loved this fucking song, and he would dance to the song, and I just. In that moment, I went back in my mind to thinking about just, like I said, the stuff about my birthday and us enjoying things, but just about him in general. Like, I saw him dancing and smiling and just saying shit that I know for a fact that I'm gonna carry with me for the rest of my life. Especially when he was just like, I wish I would. Let another person or allow another person to make me feel embarrassed about whatever the fuck I got going on, you know, whatever I do. I wish I would do some shit like that. Like, the fuck I look like. And even though the message is true when it hit so hard and it came from a fucked up individual. Even though the message came from a fucked up individual, it's real. It's a real fucking message. And irregardless of, what transpired between me and him, apparently we were meant to be together. I was meant to go through that. And I read something today that said that because Saturn went direct, you are now out of a place of having to learn lessons. You're out of that now. You are done learning all the lessons. Now it's time to put everything into motion. And I was just like, yes. Fuck yeah. Fuck yes. Because I'm just at this place now where I'm like, man, I feel like I've learned enough. Even when it came to him, I felt like I learned enough. But then being with him, I realized I hadn't. And I needed to learn a little bit more. A little bit more. I needed to do some more learning. And I know for a fact now I got the fucking messages. So, yeah. Days like this are not easy. I believe that they will get easier, but they are not easy at all. These are times where when I have thoughts of missing him and shit like that, I just be wanting to be by myself, just curl up in a ball. And just don't talk to nobody, but I'm a mom. Like, I gotta do for my kids until I got time for myself. And even then, it's like when I have the time to myself, I wanna do just about anything else other than fucking deal with my emotions. But this is what I gotta do. So, if anybody out there is going through a situation where, somebody has done you wrong, really hurt you, really hurt somebody in your family, and you are struggling with the fact that you still have really strong feelings and emotions of love tied to this person. Like you're trying to make that go away. Look, let me tell you, don't do that. Let that shit flow the way that it's flowing. It reminds you that, I'm gonna just say for me, whenever those things come up for me, I feel like it just reminds me that I have not lost sight of the fact that I know what love feels like, and I miss that, and I want that. So I'm not pushing it away because one person made me feel like whatever the fuck they made me feel like. If I fuck around and shun love and shun that love or that person or whatever for what they did, who's to say the universe don't take that and do something else with that? And, because with the universe and your spirit guides, you got to be specific. It doesn't understand, don't want you just saying some shit, and it's just gonna make some shit happen the way you say it, in a sense. So, yeah, I'm not trying to take anything away. It's just, like I said, allowing me to understand that I am human. I'm going through something. It's okay. And that I'm still open and receptive to love and the happy feeling and the good feeling. Even though right now, when I think about these situations and these moments, these different times, it makes me sad. It makes me want to cry. It makes me want to be by myself. It makes me just, it doesn't give me good feelings attached to it. But I understand that that's what love is. Love is not always going to make you feel good. It's not going to always make you smile. Sometimes love is going to make you sad. It's going to make you cry. But what kind of person would I be if I was to shun half of the experience? Now, I want to know love in all its facets. So when I'm experiencing a certain type of love that don't serve me, it don't honor my soul, I know how to manifest that shit the fuck up out of here. But I have to know what it feels like in order to do that, in order to know that I don't need it. Because if I don't know what it feels like and I just keep slapping love on it, 9 times out of 10, I'm just gonna let it go and do what the fuck it's doing. I'm not going to do anything. I'm not going to have any boundaries with it. But you got to have boundaries with love too. So, Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for showing up for yourself. I love you. Take care. I love you. Take care of yourself. Drink your water and mind your goddamn business. We're going to get through this. I'm telling you, we're going to get through this. For anybody that's having these thoughts, man, these feelings, trust me, you are not by yourself. You are not alone. You're going to get through this. And I know it sucks and it hurts to feel this way. But we're going to get through this. This is just yet another bump in the road. It's going to be all right. I fucking love you, bruh.